Hi everyone, I'm Amrita and welcome to my channel Fries and Shine. Here you will find evidence-based, no-nonsense, nutrition-related information. From our previous video, I hope you have a better understanding of what carbs really are. If you didn't get a chance to watch it yet, it's linked in the description below. Keeping with our theme of all carb this month, in today's video, I'm going to discuss the type of carb that most of us seem most aware about and seem to be having issues with. Sugar. Now we know sugar to be naturally present in some foods like fruits and vegetables, and we also know it as refined sugar, which we add to our food and to drinks like tea and coffee. Is there a difference between these kinds of sugar? Is one better than the other for our weight? Does our body distinguish between the two? So firstly, we'll discuss what natural and added sugars are and what the main difference between them is. Secondly, we'll discuss if and how our body differentiates between these two kinds of sugars. And thirdly and lastly, I'll discuss which of these you should pick to aid your weight loss, fat loss and health goals. So, what are natural and added sugars? Natural sugars are exactly that which the name suggests. They are found in nature. There are two primary sources of natural sugars. One is fruits and vegetables that we commonly know of, and two is the milk sugar lactose found in dairy and most of its products. Added sugar, on the other hand, is not found naturally in nature. Foods like sugarcane and beet undergo several refining processes, and the sugar that we eat in our tea and coffee and add to food is obtained from these refined processes. Now I know what you're thinking. What about honey and jaggery and maple syrup? These are natural sugars and naturally found in the environment too, right? So even though the sugar found in these products occurs naturally, for the sake of natural versus added sugars, they are considered a source of added sugar because we use them the same way that we would use table sugar to sweeten our food. Think about it this way. You would never buy a bottle of honey or a block of jaggery just to eat on its own, like you would a fruit. You only use honey and jaggery and maple to add sweetness or to enhance the sweetness of already existing sweet food. So does our body distinguish between natural and added sugar? Short answer, no. It absolutely does not matter where the sugar is coming from in your body. All of it ultimately gets digested and broken down into glucose and either used by the body instantly or stored for later use. So the sugar that comes from added sugar is chemically the same as natural sugar, and your body treats both of these exactly the same way. Why then do we say that natural sugar is healthier than added sugar? Now it's important to note here that when people say this, they're referring not to the sugar, but to the food. What I mean by this is, foods that contain natural sugar tend to be higher in other nutrients like fiber, B vitamins, magnesium, iron, to name a few. Added sugar, on the other hand, does give us energy, but no other nutrients. So purely from a health point of view, natural sugar can be a better choice than added sugar. In the case of fruits and vegetables, the fiber helps us feel full and also slows down the rate at which sugar is absorbed in our body, which may make it a great choice for people who are looking to control their weight and for those who have health conditions like PCOS and diabetes. Now let's take both these products. This is a chocolate and is a source of added sugar, whereas this is an apple and is a source of natural sugar. Now if you had to pick between both of these for a snack, you're better off picking the apple, even though it has sugar in it, because it also has fiber, which will keep you really full. Imagine how many chocolates you'd have to eat to get the same amount of fullness as the apple. The fiber from the apple will also slow down the absorption of the sugar from the apple. No such buffer for the chocolate. So the great thing about foods that contain natural sugars is that you generally don't need to eat too much of this food to feel full. Think about it. How many apples are you really able to eat at one time? On the other hand, how much chocolate are you really able to eat at one time? So it is the presence of all these other nutrients, which is why people say that natural sugars are better for you than added sugars. Remember though, guys, there is absolutely no chemical difference between the two. So how much added sugar can you eat in a day without it negatively impacting your health? Well, according to the Indian Council of Medical Research and the National Institute of Nutrition, no more than 30 grams per day of added sugar. According to the American Heart Association, that's about 6 teaspoons for women and 9 teaspoons for men. And it's really not hard to cross these limits. Just think about the various ways in which we add sweetness to our meals every day. Tea and coffee, breakfast foods, probably even some of your dals and sabzis have some sort of sweetness added to them. We might be hitting our added sugar limits just here. And then there are some of us who also eat desserts and chocolates in the day. So we're definitely crossing these limits. There are no limits for natural sugars because, again, it's a little hard to overconsume these foods. So, to sum it up, there is no chemical difference between natural sugar and added sugar. That being said, foods that do contain natural sugar also contain a lot of other nutrients which are great for our health. So if you can and you're able to, choose foods that contain natural sugars over those that contain added sugars to support your weight, fat loss and health goals. Saving this kind of most important note for the last. Now this in no way means that you completely need to avoid or eliminate added sugar in your diet. Some of the tastiest foods in the world contain added sugar, and we eat food for more reasons than to just nourish ourselves. So try and stick to the added sugar recommendations and try engaging in more health-promoting behaviors like regular physical activity, proper sleep, and stress management. That's all for today. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, please like it and share it with other people who may also find it helpful. Do remember once again, I'm going to be focusing on all things carb this month. So subscribe to our channel so you don't miss any of our videos. And if you have any pressing concerns or questions about carbs, please leave them either in the comments below or you can email me or you can reach out to me on Instagram to get them answered. Hope to see you soon. Until then, take care and keep shining.